हेलो एवरीवन, डियर स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 8, टू वीडियोस यू सीन चैप्टर 4 मेटल्स एंड नॉन मेटल्स. फर्स्ट वाज द इंट्रोडक्टरी पार्ट एंड सेकेंड वन यू स्टडीड अबाउट द फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ मेटल्स एंड नॉन मेटल्स. नाउ टुडे यू विल सी the chemical properties of metals as well as non-metals. How they react with water, how they react with air, what is the reaction of metals and non-metals when they react with acid and base, what is the displacement reaction. These all things you will study today. Okay, let's begin the chapter topic, and it is the chemical properties of metals and non-metals. Okay, this topic we will discuss today. Students, first of all, we have to learn the reactivity series. This is potassium, calcium, sodium, magnesium. This is the reactivity series, like afterward aluminium, zinc, iron, hydrogen, and later word, there are many things like the copper, mercury, silver, gold. You can write them like copper, potassium, calcium, sodium, magnesium, aluminium, zinc, iron, hydrogen, copper, mercury, silver, gold. You can write here platinum also. So this is the series of reactivity. Series of reactivity means metals which is on top is reactive, and this is continued. Okay, this is the most reactive and this is least reactive among them. Okay, so you have to learn this reactivity series. If you will learn this reactivity series, it will become very easy to understand how metals react with acids, how metals react with bases, how metals react with water, how metals react with air. Let's begin it. Reaction with air. Air means, you can say here, oxygen. Okay, you see here, these are the metals. So let's see about the reactivity of metals, reaction with air. Metals, according to their reactivity series, react with air. Like if we take the example of magnesium, then 2 magnesium plus 1 molecule of oxygen, they react and form oxide. What is this? Is magnesium, this, you know, oxygen, and this is magnesium oxide. Similarly, you can take any one of them. Okay, like aluminium, it will make aluminium oxide Al2O3. Okay, aluminium, 2 aluminium plus O2 Al2O3. Okay, so this will be the aluminium oxide. Okay, so all metals react with the oxygen and form their oxides. Dear students, do you know this magnesium combined with oxygen on heating on air? Okay, जैसे दिवाली में फूलझड़ी हम लोग जलाते हैं, dazzling light, colorful light. So similar, if magnesium strip is got heated, it will react with oxygen with dazzling light and it will form its oxide. The nature of oxide, metallic oxides, means oxides of metal, is basic. Do you know basic, acid and base? Okay, what is acid, what is base? Do you know there is a scale that is called a pH scale, and this pH scale varies from 0 to 14. Okay, the pH scale varies from 0 to 14. pH scale varies from 0 to 14. Whenever the school will open, I will show you the pH scale. On this scale, if you find the pH between 0 to 7, pH between 0 to 7, it will be acid. And if pH is 7 to 14, it will be a base. Okay? And how we will identify, how will we test this pH? So this based on the color. One more thing you studied in your previous class, that is the litmus paper. Use of litmus paper also show whether a given solution is base or acid. Have you remember what was that? Dear students, base are those substances in which red litmus turns to blue. Which one? When red turns to blue. Red turns to blue. This will be the base, litmus, red litmus paper when dipped in a solution and its color changes to blue, that so the given solution is base. Okay, so all metals react with oxygen more or less depending on the reactivity series. Like this one, react vigorously, they will react vigorously, they will react rapidly, they will react some slowly. Okay, and likewise, they react very slowly or there will be no reaction based on the reactivity series. Those who are on top, they will react vigorously, and those who are at the bottom, they react very slow or there will be no reaction. Okay, so all metals more or less react with oxygen, means air, and produce their oxides, and these oxides are basic in nature. And how we find their basic nature? By using the litmus paper. Okay? Take some magnesium strip, heat it, and collect the ash oxide in any utensil, mix it with water, and that mixed water will be tested when by litmus paper. it will give blue color, that will show the given solution is base. Okay, non-metals also react with oxygen, like if you take carbon is a non-metal, and if this carbon react with oxygen, okay, and if oxygen is in limited supply, then it will form oxide that is called what? Carbon monoxide. Why carbon monoxide? Oxygen is only one. The word mono is a scientific word which means one. Whenever the word is di, it means two. The word mono means one, the word di means two, the word tri means three. Okay, it is the counting. Tri means three. Okay, so whenever it is written tri, okay, so then it will be three. When it will be written di, it will be one. When it will be written mono, it will be one. Okay, mono means one, di means two, and tri means three. So when carbon react with oxygen in limited supply of which oxygen, it will form the carbon monoxide gas. Carbon monoxide gas is very poisonous gas, and it is high affinity to combine with the hemoglobin. Do you know hemoglobin? Hemoglobin is present in the red blood corpuscles in our blood. Because of hemoglobin, the blood looks red, and that red pigment is called hemoglobin. This carbon monoxide combine with hemoglobin and create poison, nervous poison, means suffocation, and a person can die. This often happens during the winter when someone sleep in the room by packing all the ventilators and doors, and by lighting the coal in the room for heat. That coal produce carbon monoxide in burning, and that carbon monoxide enters in the body, suffocate, and lungs will not get the sufficient oxygen, and the person will die due to suffocation. Very poisonous gas is carbon monoxide. This carbon can also produce, if oxygen is sufficient. What is sufficient? Enough, excess, then it will form oxide that is called, you studied it, it is called carbon dioxide. You see here, oxygen is 2, that's why it is called dioxide. Okay, so non-metals also react with air, produce their oxides. What about the nature? Their nature is just opposite. Nature of non-metallic oxides are acidic. Their nature is acidic. Okay, acidic nature will what to blue litmus paper turns to red, then the solution will be acidic. Okay, so oxides, metallic oxides are acidic in nature. Non-metallic oxides are acidic in nature, while metallic oxides are basic in nature, and their nature can be identified by using the litmus paper. Those whose pH is between 7 to 14, they are called base, and if pH lies between 0 to 7, the substance will call the acid. Okay, so this is the reaction of metals and non-metals with air. Now, what will happen when they will react with water? Okay, reactions with water. With water. Do you know the formula of water? H2O. It is a non-metallic compound. Hydrogen is also non-metal and oxygen is also non-metal. Both are gases. Okay? Look here. Suppose we take this sodium or calcium, anyone, sodium plus water. What do you think? What will be the reaction? NaOH plus hydrogen gas. Okay? So now you can see here. 2, 2, 4. Okay. So metals react with water and produce hydroxide and hydrogen gas evolve. Okay, then this will be with all depending on their reactivity series, like potassium also form KOH. Okay, so this will be, you can write here, potassium plus H2O, this will produce the KOH or plus H2. You can balance this 2, 2, 4. 2, 2, 2. 2, 2, 2, 4. Okay. So this way. They react vigorously. These are very reactive metals. Potassium, calcium, sodium, and they are very soft also. Because of their vigorous nature of reactivity with air and water, sodium or potassium are kept in kerosene. Okay? Potassium and sodium are kept in kerosene. Kerosene, you know? Mitti ka tel. Kerosene oil. Okay? Because kerosene do not have the dissolved water molecules or air molecules in it, that's why they do not react in that. So they are kept in kerosene because they are very reactive. And they react with water and produce their hydroxide. And you know, hydroxide are basic in nature. Okay? Dear students, non-metals generally do not react with water. Non-metals generally do not react with water. They can react, but in certain condition, in certain artificial conditions. Okay? So this is the reaction of metals and they produce their hydroxide. Now, the reaction of metals and non-metals with acid. What will happen? Do you know acids? What are acids? Acids are those substances who have the capability to give protons, means hydrogen. Like you can take the example HCl. What is hydrochloric acid? You know, in previous class you also studied that this is present in our stomach, secreted by the gastric glands to kill the bacteria and create a medium for the activation of protein digestive enzyme, that is pepsin. Okay, this HCl break down to produce hydrogen. So this is plus charge proton, if you remember the first lecture. Okay, so they have the capability to release proton And such type of solutions, such type of substances are called acids. Okay, some acids are edible also, like lemon juice, orange, pickle. They all are sharp and they all have the acids. Look here. Just take the example of sodium and plus HCl. Okay. This will react and produce NaCl plus hydrogen ion. Okay. This NaCl is sodium chloride. Sodium chloride, common salt that we eat every day. Common salt. Okay. This common salt, white salt, which we use every day for many purposes. So metals react with acids, produce their salts, and salts, you know, salts are generally neutral in nature, but depend on the acid or base, they can be acidic or basic also. Okay, and they also produce by the reaction of neutralization. When acid reacts with base, this is the previous class, class 7. Okay, so metals react with acid and produce their salts and hydrogen gas. You can see many, like magnesium plus hydrochloric acid, they will also MgCl2 or plus hydrogen. Okay. Equation can be balanced like 2. Okay. Dear students, here a reason I want to make you know that metals are high affinity to react with acids. That's why edible items which type sharp, जो खट्टे जिनमें एसिड होता है, should not keep in metallic bases. Okay, इसीलिए कई बार ये सलाह दी जाती है कि sharp items like pickles you should not keep in the metallic vessels because they can react with acid and produce some poison that can harm us. Okay, so metals react with acid and produce hydrogen gas by producing their sharps. Non-metals also react with acid. Like you can take the example of sulfur is a non-metal, and this sulfur can react with acid like HNO3. This is royal acid. You can write its name nitric acid called. It is called nitric acid. Okay, and it will produce H2SO4, another type of acid, plus NO2, nitrogen oxide, and plus water. Okay, sulfur plus nitric acid, this will produce H2SO4, sulfuric acid, plus nitrogen oxide, and plus water. Okay, this is nitric acid, this is sulfuric acid, sulfuric acid, this is nitrogen oxide, and this is water. You can balance the equation. Okay, like NN, you can write here 6 6 6 and 6 and 2 2 2 4 4 or 2 6 6 nitrogen 6 6 here hydrogen 6 6 here oxygen 18 4 is here 12 is here 4 is here okay so this is sulfuric acid this is non metal which type of reaction non metal with acid okay dear students non metals also react with acid and they produce another acid H2SO4 sulfuric acid nitrogen oxide and water how not only this depending on the reactivity series of non metals okay now the next in this sequence is reaction with bases bases are also react with metals first we study about the metals bases react with metals like zinc plus sodium hydroxide what do you think what will be the reaction it will be sodium zincate Na2ZnO2 it is called what sodium zincate plus what they will release non metals reaction of non metals with base is very complex and this is just beginning of the chemistry so in your syllabus you need not to study about the reaction of non metals with base okay so metals react with base they produce their salt this is also a type of salt okay and they produce the hydrogen gas not only in base also in water also and in acid also they will react means metals will react and produce the hydrogen gas okay now another reaction is there that is called the displacement reaction displace means one metal or non metal replace the another metal or non metal so who can replace who has the more capacity the more capable metal or non metal displace the less capable metals or non metals you can take the example here like iron plus copper sulfate this you will also can do at your home take some solution of copper sulfate that is blue in color and put an iron nail in it after some time you will observe that a yellowish reddish substance has been deposited over the iron nail and the color of solution also turns green that means you see here ferrous iron and copper see here iron and copper is below the iron okay so iron is more reactive than copper so iron will replace the copper from its solution okay look here iron F E S O 4 and plus copper. This is blue color, but this become green. What happened? This iron replaces the copper, okay, and copper displaced here. Similarly, this is about the metals. Means more reactive metals can replace the less reactive metals. Similarly, non-metals also. Non-metals like chlorine plus sodium bromide. Okay, this is bromine. Chlorine, bromine, iodine, they are all called the halogens, belongs to the same family. We will study later. This chlorine replaces this bromine and this will become 2NaCl. NaCl and plus Br2. You know, bromine is the only non-metal that found in liquid state. You studied that in physical property of metals and non-metals. Okay, so this is the displacement reaction. Displacement reaction is that reaction in which more reactive metal or non-metal replace the less reactive metal or non-metal from its solution. That type of reaction is called displacement reaction. So dear students, in this chapter, only this you have to study in the chemical properties of metals and non-metals, while there are many reactions. As you will study in further classes, you will able to get those. But at this level, you have to study only these type of reactions, simple reactions, common reactions. Okay. In next video, I will make you know about the atomic number, atomic mass, arrangement of electrons, as well as the use of metals and non-metals. Okay. Till then, stay home, see the video, subscribe, like and share. Comment also and enjoy yourself, study properly. Thank you very much.